So Samsung has just announced not 2, but 4 Samsung Galaxy S10 series of smartphones. So I'm here to help you differentiate each of them, and hopefully you'll find the right phone for your next purchase. So let's start with the base model, the Samsung Galaxy S10. The Samsung Galaxy S10 is beautifully crafted with the new edge-to-edge display, which they call it the Infinity O display. It comes with a hole punch design, which is located at the top right corner of the smartphone, where the front-facing cameras will be located. From the back of the phone, the new Galaxy S10 do remind me a lot of the Note 9's clean and boxy look. But that's actually not a bad thing. Have you seen the new Prism White chassis? It shimmers like the mother of pearl, and I bet that this will be the popular color for this season. And to maintain that clean and chic look, it is the first ever display that's embedded with an ultrasonic fingerprint scanner. The ultrasonic fingerprint scanners reads 3D contours of your thumbprints, which highly improves on anti-spoofing and the security of your smartphone. Unlike some fingerprint scanners which only take 2D images, this is definitely a more secure way to unlock your phone. Featuring the world's first dynamic AMOLED display, it will deliver vivid digital playback of your favorite content via its dynamic tone mapping technology. This 6.1-inch Quad HD Plus curved display also makes the Galaxy S10 the first smartphone to be HDR10 Plus certified. Paired with Dolby Atmos surround sound, you will have the best movie experience on the go in terms of visual and sound. The Galaxy S10 is also the first S-series smartphone to feature triple camera system. The newly added lens now gives you the ability to take ultra-wide angle shots with an impressive 123 degrees field of view. So now you will be able to capture more within a shorter distance. Combined with the new Super Steady digital stabilization technology, your Galaxy S10 is ready to rock like an action camera. You can even choose your video to record in Ultra HD and as well as HDR10 Plus quality. Best of all, the Galaxy S10 is still water resistant with IP68 standard and still comes with a headphone jack for your wired music experience. The new wireless power share now lets you charge up to 30% faster on Qi certified devices, and now you can even use your Galaxy S10 to charge up other wireless charging smartphones as well as compatible wearable devices. For example, the new Galaxy Bud and the Galaxy smartwatches. How cool is that? That's quite a long description for all the new and notable features on just one smartphone. For the next three phones from the Galaxy S10 series, I will just cover on the differences that they have with the Galaxy S10. The Galaxy S10 Plus will come with an exclusive premium ceramic variant, which I am totally in love with it. The ceramic white Galaxy S10 Plus with that rose gold trimmings on the sides. Oh my god, it's just super chill lah. Other than the bigger 6.4-inch Quad HD Plus display, the Galaxy S10 Plus also comes with dual front-facing cameras. The extra camera will be a RGB depth camera, which I assume will give you better bokeh shots than the Galaxy S10 when taking portrait selfie with the front camera. The Galaxy S10 Plus is also the only variant in the series which comes with 1TB of internal storage. So if you need more space for all those content on your smartphone, I think the Galaxy S10 Plus is the choice for you. Oh, and I forgot to mention earlier that all the variants in the Galaxy S10 series will actually come with a micro SD card slot where it would be able to support up to 512GB of storage. So moving on, if you're not interested in curved screen display, the Galaxy S10e will be the only variant in the series with a flat screen. It is also priced at $150 cheaper than the base model of the Galaxy S10. So there will be some compromise in features. Instead of a triple camera system, the Galaxy S10e will only have dual camera system. It will come without the 2x optical zoom, but it will still have the ultra wide angle lens, which I think most of us will adore. The fingerprint scanner is also not on screen, but it is still discreet as it is now embedded onto the power button at the side. As for the Galaxy S10 5G, it will only launch on a later date in selected markets. It will be the first Galaxy smartphone with 5G connectivity, so you will expect fast connecting speed with this model. It will also have the largest display ever to be found on the Galaxy S series at 6.7 inch. It will also feature a 3D depth camera which will be capturing 3D imaging, and it will also come with 4500 mAh battery capacity, which is the largest in this series of smartphones. It will also come with a 25-watt super fast charging feature. Pricing and other details will only be announced closer to the launch date. So I hope with this video, you have a better understanding on each variant of the Galaxy S10 series of smartphones. So do leave us a comment on which one is your favorite. Do help us by liking and sharing this video with your friends on social media. And do remember to subscribe to us if you like our content. Your support will be very encouraging for us to create better content in the near future. See ya!